which we feel that we got to get beyond before God can freely pull out of on us all of the things that we
miss. We got to get our children back to some kind of. They don't have no kind of morals in their body.
Respect.
No respect. No morals. No. Woo! And you can just kill a person, just bam, and just keep on going and never really? Look back and just no morals in their body. And they young people. Young children, we don't get our children back on.
Lost fear of God.
Yes.
We lost the fear of God. Mm-hmm. All right, fear of God, the wholesome dread of displeasing God. That's
no
that runs across the
no guidance.
No guidance from their parents and stuff.
Right.
And this drug dealing and stuff.
Yeah.
The police is pushing that more than that. They got 7 kilos of cocaine and whatever. They never tell you what happened to this cocaine they didn't got. They put it back on the streets themselves. Politics and these police, they tough. It's rough.
Right. Bikes is speaking about is good, because I think that until we get a conviction of the need to intercede for the conditions of people around us, you know, we don't have to be a long ways away. Sometimes it's our own family.
Yeah.
But something got to drive us to a point where we get concerned about our own. Conviction that I need to intercede, I need to push my plate back, I need to get into the Word, I need to line up with the Word so that I can be effective in helping to turn some of the conditions that I can do something about around. And I think if all of us would just receive that, because the Scripture says if you want more mercy, then you're going to have to be what? Merciful. See, that's the key to receiving more mercy, that you're going to have to, once we learn how God is, then we are to what? Emulate. We are to follow His example. Whatever God is like, that's what we are to be what? Alike. The Bible says Jesus who went about doing good, healing all of those that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. And I had this written down, but I didn't know I knew it would have time to go to it. See, Job received mercy after he prayed for his friend. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And see, he was, you know, he had a lot of issues against his friends. But when he released his hostility, bitterness, and anxiety, God turned the captivity of Job when he prayed for his friends. But he still had to offer the sacrifice. He still had to repent, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. So that was the manhood side of it. Okay. But is a lot in being merciful. The parable of the Good Samaritan who rescued the man that fell among thieves, he was applauded for his compassion. Jesus spoke very well of him. He said, go ye and do what? Likewise. So I think that all of this is teaching us that when we learn about Christ's compassion, this is something that we need to begin to what? Release to others. And until we begin to release compassion and really begin to reach out and place ourselves in a position where God can equip us to reach out to others, then God is going to withhold a lot of the mercy that we're supposed to be receiving. Because the Bible says, with the merciful, this is Psalms 18:25, thou wilt show thyself merciful. With the upright man, thou wilt show thyself upright. And the Scripture also says, blessed are the merciful, for they shall what? Obtain mercy. So I think one of the greatest needs we have in the church today is that we really need to begin to pray and really get placed in the position where God can really restore to us, amen, concern for others, yes. compassion yes. and love for others.
Yes.
Amen. So this is the reason why we this week we want to reach out to our sisters and brothers. Somehow, sister Bikes, you're going to have to help me with this. I believe this morning we had 15.
Amen.
Yeah, 15 in prayer. We had about the same amount yesterday morning, a few less. But we've had prayer every morning, and we had it every evening. We're going to do it all week. Mm-hmm. Amen. And so what happens is that the Lord is raising up compassion. Mm-hmm. And the Lord's spoken to me. So go into homes and people that have never come to this church. I mean, haven't been here in a long time, Go out and just show your love, show your compassion. Okay, let's try that this way. Get on the phone. Get right, get on the phone. Let's reach out and let's see how many people will be drawn here Sunday through our compassion. It doesn't make sense for us to name the name of the Lord, and on Sunday, all the pews are what? Empty. And here we are just receiving all that we can get. Amen. But if our joy is to be full, then we're going to what? Have compassion on others. Because that's the reason why God is what? Releasing his compassion to us, so that we can what? Take that compassion. Amen. And begin to what? Even reach out to others. Amen. Let's praise God. So let's continue to focus on prayer number 3132. If you master that, you'll have a picture, the complete picture of what we are trying to convey this week. And also prayer for me. Because this is the prayer that's designed to stir you up so that you can begin to be more concerned about others. This is a prayer for me and a prayer for the lost. Prayer for me and a prayer for the lost. Amen. Somehow God got to restore that compassion for the lost in our hearts. And I believe this is the time and the season for God to do that. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. All right, we just thank God for all of you tonight. Amen. See everybody. Did you have this morning today? Was it here this morning?
I just want to say, I want to give thanks to Sister Wayne because she's been interceding for me and my healing. And, that's kind of why I'm here tonight, baby.
Yeah.
Because I want to give glory to her. She's been in my. She's called me. We went to. Saturday and Sunday, I couldn't walk. I've been on my walker.
Mm-hmm.
And Sister Wayne had me on her heart, and she called. And we got together on Monday, and we went to Y, and she did the water aerobics. And so. She's been interceding for me.
That's good.
I just want everybody to know.
Amen.
I give her.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen. Sister Hova this morning was saying that she's been in prayer every morning. She said that, every night, like the last 2 nights.
Mm-hmm.
And she said that all of her pain is gone too.
Man, it's on the way out.
Mm-hmm.
I can walk.
But she had a lot of pain on a daily basis with her legs and her. Been hurting her for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
So she is feeling a lot better. Amen. So what happened tonight for the Pachecos?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they were here, the first ones here. Yeah.
Yeah.
I was hesitating about that.
Yeah.
I was hesitating. I didn't know if it was such a good idea.
All right, well, we thank God for Sister Mary Ann tonight.
Amen.
I always keep up with me, and if I don't call her, she keeps thinking I don't know. But she's pretty good. She's like a busy lady, but she's pretty good about coming to Wednesday night.
Amen.
She's in town.
Amen.
All right, so the next few weeks, since first of the year, we all want to work for getting completely inland. Get in position where everything God has for us can be what? Amen. Can be released into our lives. So whatever lining up we need to do, how many believe it is better to line up? And the things that we give up ain't nothing compared to what God has in store for them that love Him. Let's all stand and we'll dismiss tomorrow morning at 5 o'clock. Tomorrow evening at 7 o'clock. Friday morning at 5 o'clock and Friday evening at 7 p.m. Amen. Praise God. So happy for our brothers that's been consistent in the morning. Amen. Brother Sam was there this morning. Amen. We had a good prayer meeting. Amen. Come as much as you can, Brother Sam. Yes. All right. These brothers hanging there with me, boy, I'm telling you, it's powerful. Travis been released back, and Brother Al is very thankful. He's been coming every morning. He and his wife, amen. We just thank God, all of you. So we expect you, if you don't get in it this week, amen, you'll have several more weeks coming up. You'll catch you on somewhere down the line. Now may the grace of God, Sister Panola, we thank God for you. I don't hold my mind today. I was going to call you and give you some assignment because this prayer meeting is going to go in a long time. We need you. We need you. Amen. Praise God. Now unto him that is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before his presence with exceeding great joy,
yes,
to the only wise God, our Savior,
yes,
be glory, yes, honor, dominion, and power, both now and forever. Everybody said, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. 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 Hallelujah.